And here we go, folks. I love this music. All right, so let's talk about mark making. Now, mark making, it describes the different lines, patterns, and textures made visible. That's pretty much what you do to make a picture or a painting or a sculpture. Let me get rid of this stuff. All right, I'm digging this music. Here we go. Now, this is a line. It's just a mark. Well, a mark is a line and a line is a mark. Now, the more marks I make, the more and more and more I make, and the more I group them together, I start to change things. Now, the lines that are grouped together are getting darker, they're getting wider, they're getting more mass, they're starting to show form and have a different feel. So if I was drawing hair, those lines that are grouped together, those marks that are put together, well, they kind of make it seem like the hair is, bunched up, darker, or, you know, part of a curl. Now, there's another way of making marks, hatching. Hatching is just a series of parallel lines. Now, it's no different than the one we saw before. The other one was a little more free flow, but hatching is parallel lines. Now, these are usually about a quarter of an inch to a half inch in length. Same thing about grouping them together. If I group them together tight, it's gonna look like they're more compressed and more darker in values. Now, they have a brother or a sister or a cousin that they call cross hatching. Now, cross hatching is where you do hatching, same quarter inch, half inch, but then you come back and you hatch over those with another set of lines. If you group those together nice and tight, then you're getting a really cool dark area. That'll be good for showing value and shading. So that's another way of making marks. Okay, now, oh, I love this music. You have no idea how happy that music makes me. All right, scribbling. Scribbling is awesome. It's not just what you do in DMC, it's also used for art. You can just kind of make marks, but once again, going back to that whole darkness, mass, volume, distance thing that's going on by grouping things together, if you scribble nice and tight and dark, you're gonna get mass, you're gonna get form starting to develop. It's gonna be a good way to add texture, value, and tone to your artwork. All right, now, the last but not least is stippling. It's just a lot of dots, 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 dots. This takes a long time. It never ends, but once again, group them together, group them tight, you're gonna start to get mass, you're gonna start to get form, you're gonna start to show things that are farther away from the light, and you start to communicate a different feeling. All right, so now we know what mark making is, and we're gonna use that in that artwork we're doing right now. All right, now let's talk a little bit about line variation. Now, line variation is just, in art, line is defined as a point moving through space, and there are five main types of lines. Now, here we go. Let me erase this up. Scrubba, scrubba, scrubba. All right, and the first line that we're gonna work with is a vertical line, straight up and down. A vertical straight up and line is really strong. It kind of gives a statement of like, this thing is formed. Now, if you take that line and you lay it flat, then it becomes horizontal. It's more restful. It's a more peaceful line. So just think about that when you're making lines. Now, zigzag lines are also used. Now, zigzag lines are energetic, they're active, they're a little harsher, and they kind of bring excitement into an artwork. All right, now the opposite of that is gonna be the curve line. Oh, music, please come back, yes. Now, the curve line is soft, it's beautiful, it's very seductive. Now, there's also that line that's the diagonal. That's in between a vertical and a horizontal. Well, that one is just, oh my God, it's getting ahead of me. Oh, line weight, let me jump here, line weight. Line weight pretty much is about the heaviness and darkness and lightness of a line. If I take a line and I'm able to show different weights of it, I'm able to add some depth into my artwork. So if I'm drawing a circle and I keep a single line, it's just gonna be a shape. But if you see here how I'm using a thinner line on top, getting thicker and thicker and the thickest all the way to the bottom, well then it's not just gonna look like a circle. It's going to be the idea of a sphere. Let me pull that top. So you see the bottom one is just a circle, one dimension, one line. But the top one has a little bit more mass, a little bit more light and shadow. Okay, guys, I hope this helps. Take care, stay clean.